The first U.S. president ever to grant a sit-down meeting with North Korea's leader is now admitting the follow-up is not going as he had hoped. President Trump is now calling off a U.S. trip to North Korea over lack of progress on nuclear disarmament. It has been nearly 2.5 months since his summit with Kim Jong-un. And just a short time ago, he tweeted this: "I have asked Secretary of State Mike Pompeo not to go to North Korea at this time because I feel we are not making sufficient progress with respect to the denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula." Joining us now, CNN senior diplomatic correspondent Michelle Kaczynski and CNN political analyst Josh Rogan, who is also a columnist for The Washington Post. Michelle, this trip was just announced yesterday. Why the about face?
I know. This is perplexing, especially since through our sources, we knew days ago that this trip was planned. So we started to think, okay, that must mean that the North Koreans have possibly, at the very least, showed some willingness to play ball this time, since things have been going badly. I mean, it was only a couple of weeks ago we heard the National Security Advisor saying that things were not where they wanted them to be, even in the process of getting started on the path towards denuclearization. So then yesterday they have this big event where they gathered the press at the State Department. Secretary of State announced that we have a new envoy to North Korea now. They're all going to North Korea next week. You know, good news, it seemed. We did ask the State Department just yesterday, does this mean that this is because there's been some additional progress? They wouldn't say anything about it. Then all of a sudden today, the president, via a series of tweets, announces that this isn't happening, that no, there appears to be no progress, but he makes it all about China. He says that China isn't helping in this process, and let's maybe wait and see and get together soon with the North Koreans once we work out the trade deal with China. So it seems like this is absolutely coming from the White House, possibly more to do with trade with China than anything changing on the North Korean side, because things have not been going well there. But what is the State Department saying about this right now? Absolutely nothing, Anna.
Crickets. Josh, right after the summit with Kim Jong-un, Trump hailed in a tweet that there was, quote, no longer a nuclear threat from North Korea. And now he's admitting it's not going well. This is really a change in tone, and one that doesn't come often from this president.
What we're seeing is that Trump's private frustration with the progress of the North Korea nuclear diplomacy spilling out into public view, actually, for the very first time. And what that reflects is a change in the internal battle inside the top level of the Trump administration over what's going on, how bad is it, and what we should do about it. National Security Advisor John Bolton, but not just Bolton, a lot of others, have been pushing the president privately to take what they call a more realistic approach, but what others call a more hawkish approach. And that means talking tough to Kim Jong-un, acknowledging what they see as the reality that there has been no progress to denuclearization, and considering a pivot to a stance that's more public, more confrontational, and might include more pressure mechanisms like sanctions. And it seems that today those hardliners have won the day, because the president is now taking that exact public position. Now, that doesn't mean we know what's going to happen tomorrow. Remember, this could be a tactical play by the president. Yeah. Right before the Singapore summit, he canceled the summit and everybody panicked. And then a few days later, it was back on when Kim Jong-un did something to prove that he was still interested. So we have to entertain the possibility that the president is sending a signal to North Korea and also to China: cut the crap, get going on the things that we want you to get going on, and then everything can be okay again. And one last thing is that when the president says at the end, "I look forward to seeing you soon, but you're not going to see Mike Pompeo," well, isn't he cutting his own top diplomat off at the knees by canceling his trip one day later and saying, "Kim Jong-un, deal with me. I'm the president. And we'll talk about dealing with Pompeo at some other time." It's pretty astounding.
Or is he trying to have it both ways, sort of maintain the close friendship, so to speak,
sticks and
with
carrots,
Kim Jong-un, but at the same time saying you're not going to have a talk
impossible
with us?
You wrote...
Go ahead, Michelle.
You have President Trump at the same time simultaneously in his own self playing good cop, bad cop here, and signing this series of tweets like regards and respect and look forward to seeing you soon, as if something is going to happen soon. But he's saying, you know, we're going to play hardball, but I have a lot of respect for you and look forward to seeing you. I mean, it's really hard to figure out what is going on here and what the U.S. side wants to see. And U.S. allies are saying the same. They're reacting to this like, what's going on? And they're not getting a lot of answers either.
And Josh, you wrote a piece right before this announcement about this being a moment of truth for Secretary of State Mike Pompeo going to North Korea on this issue of denuclearization. What is the reality about what's happening inside North Korea when it comes to its nuclear program?
Well, while there have been several steps to build confidence and reduce tensions, like bringing home remains of U.S. soldiers, stopping missile tests, and those are all good things, on the actual denuclear track, there has been little to zero progress, okay? And the last time Mike Pompeo went to Pyongyang, he didn't even get a meeting with Kim. The North Koreans blasted him as soon as they left. It was largely viewed as a humiliation. Now, this time, there is a good chance that that could happen again, and that would have been a huge blow to our whole diplomatic effort. It was a risk that Mike Pompeo was willing to take, along with his new special envoy, Steve Bagan, who was going to go to Pyongyang with him. And now they've decided not to take that risk, okay? And that just shows you that there is an acknowledgement inside this administration that this is not going as well as they want it to. They feel like they have to do something different. And Mike Pompeo wanted to just keep pushing to try to unjam this thing. And he got overruled, okay? And now he can't go. And now we have to wait for Kim Jong-un to make the next move.
Josh Rogan, Michelle Kaczynski, thank you both.